Hello, I am Marcy. I'm back to present part 2 of the demonstration video I call The Big Gestalt. In part 1, I outlined a simple experiment whereby we will record EEG signals from Mark while presenting a flash of light. Here in part 2, I will demonstrate how to implement this experiment in Synapse. I will first build and run the experiment without the artifact blocking. Then, I will show you just how easy it is to make changes to your experiment in Synapse by adding and connecting these elements. We start here, in the idle or edit screen in Synapse. I've already made myself the current user. So now I need to create a new experiment and subject. Both of these tasks are accomplished using just a few mouse clicks via the control bar buttons. Simply click Experiment and choose New. When the dialog appears, type a name for your experiment and select an icon. Choose one that will help you identify the experiment at a glance when it's selected in the future. Click Save and a new blank experiment will be created, ready for you to edit. Now, click on Subject and select New. In the dialog, enter the subject's identifier and choose an appropriate icon. As you can see, I'm being kind in my selection of Mark's icon. Click Save and your new subject has been created and made active as the current subject. As we think about building our experiment, we think first about the signal source, the PZ5 amplifier. It will collect the very small signals from Mark's brain and amplify them for processing and storage by Synapse. Click on the PZ5 in the processing tree, and its options dialog will appear. Now I'll set it up for operation with the proper number of channels using settings appropriate for EEG recording. When all is as you wish, click Commit to save these settings to your experiment. This demonstration is about understanding signal flow and Gizmo connections. I'm going to show you all the ways Synapse helps you visualize this flow in your experimental designs. One way is by enabling a panel called the processing strip. This strip offers a linear look at the primary signal flow upstream from the selected gizmo. I'll enable it now via the preferences dialog and demonstrate its use a bit later. With the processing strip visible, let's continue building our experiment. The next component needed, as we look at our data flow, is a filter. Go to the Gizmo selection panel and expand the signal conditioning category. When it is revealed, select the general purpose filter. Drag this gizmo and drop it on the PZ5 and the processing tree. The general purpose filter gizmo has 6 cascaded filter sections that can be configured by you. In this case, we will be using the high pass at 1 Hz and the low pass at 200 Hz. Also, we will enable a notch filter to remove any 60 Hz interference from the power mains. To accept these changes in the dialog, press the Commit button. Now we need to add a storage gizmo, so our filter DEGs will be saved to disk. Click the storage category in the Gizmo selection panel. When it's revealed, drag Stream Store onto the Filter1 gizmo in the processing tree. Now we can make adjustments to the Stream Storage gizmo using its setup dialog. We'll change its 4-digit storage code to better match the signal type we are saving. Click Commit to save these changes to the experiment. Looking at the processing tree and processing strip, we can see that the gizmo configuration here matches our intended experiment from part 1. This experiment is ready to run. Remember, we still must add our artifact rejection gizmo. But just for fun, let's take a look at some data recorded from what we have currently. As you can see, by simply clicking the preview button, we can begin to look at the results of our experiment. To be fair, the traces you see here are generated using a fake brain. Mark's actual EEGs would be far less interesting. By clicking idle, we go back into idle or edit mode. Note, that I've replaced the PZ5 as the source of our EEG signals with a fake brain gizmo. This relieves me having to deal with an uncooperative Mark. We can now modify our experiment to include the artifact rejection gizmo. Also, we will connect its on-off or trigger control to an input signal of the RZ processor. We need to place the artifact blocking gizmo just after the signal source, and just before the filter gizmo. So I'll select the fake brain and then add the artifact blocking gizmo into the signal path. Note, the filter and stream store gizmos are still not properly ordered. Looking at the processing strip, we can see they are still sourced directly by the fake brain. To rectify this, simply drag the filter gizmo and drop it on the artifact blocking gizmo to properly order the processing. Now, a review of the processing strip shows the proper ordering of gizmos in our experiment. This is probably a good time to explain a bit more about how gizmos are linked together in an experiment. As I've said previously, Synapse is a signal-driven system. This means that gizmos are connected together and ordered by the signals that flow between them. Looking at the tree, or strip views, we can quickly review the primary or key links between the gizmos of our experiment. Be aware, every gizmo must have at least one input, so that it can be connected to a parent element within the processing tree. While not depicted in the tree or strip, many gizmos have secondary inputs and outputs as well. The secondary inputs are reviewed and connected via the connections panel in a gizmo's dialog. This panel is revealed by pressing the connections button when an item is selected in the tree. The filter gizmo has only one input and one output. Thus, no additional information is revealed by the connections panel for this gizmo. The artifact reject gizmo, however, has both a secondary input and a secondary output. I will speak here only about the secondary input and its function. It's worth noting that some gizmos, such as stream store, have no outputs. These are terminal gizmos, and nothing can be connected downstream of them. You'll notice that when these items are selected in the tree, no items will be shown in the gizmo selection panel. Synapse has a third very nice way to look at all connections between the components of your experiment. At the top of the processing tree, click the puzzle piece button to show this additional view. The connections diagram shows both the primary and secondary signal connections within an experiment. Additionally, this diagram depicts signal types and signal channel counts. More on that in another demo. Notice that the trigger input for the artifact reject gizmo is connected to something called sweep fire. Sweep fire is a system-wide logic signal that ticks once every second while your experiment is running. When a gizmo is added to an experiment, Synapse will try to connect its inputs to appropriate source signals. If none can be found, or multiple choices exist, a selection dialog will appear when the gizmo is added. Here, we see the system chose sweep fire as the most reasonable connection for the trigger input. In part 3 of this demo, I'm going to show you how to reconnect the trigger input such that it suits the needs of our experiment. I'm sure you are ready for a break. I know I am. I'll see you soon for part 3 of this demo. Bye for now.